Yeah, oh my Lord, watch me sway. Darkness falls and we all pray, hoping for the light of day. Down to the river, I have held the devil's hand, felt the weight of my own sin, burdened by the heart of man. Down to the river, down to the river.
G-Shrek! You're up on this point. From what they say, there's two ways up. I haven't seen the second one yet, but look at that. Look at this wall that runs this ridgeline. Look how incredible that is. Unbelievable. Tell you what, look at the view. What I'm gonna do is get this camera up as high as I can, then I'm gonna give you a 360 degree view of this place. It's a place you probably won't get to too many times. The amount of work it takes to get up here, and then just look at this place. Look at these rocks here. How incredible is that? Man. So there's your defenses there. I'm guessing there's petroglyphs around this ridgeline. There's an alternative way to get down to see that other ridgeline. We're definitely going to take it. But you know what? If I had to choose whether to be an attacking position or a defensive position in this location, I would have definitely chosen to be in the defensive. Because isn't this place just unbelievable? Look off of this, walls. How spectacular is this? Nobody could come up any of these hills without you definitely having an unbelievable advantage over anyone that would try to come up this ridge. Wow, just beautiful. Tell you what, you know, I want to thank everybody that donates to the channel. And the reason I say that is because I couldn't do this kind of stuff without the support and help of everybody out there. And I tell you what, it means the world to me. And I hope you enjoy coming along to experience this as much as I do getting to do it. You know, the old knee was hurting a little bit today, but I took my time. I didn't try to race it. I took my time, just like I'm gonna do when I go down. And I'm gonna really savor this moment up here because this is a special place. Now again, why was there four forts in this little area? One would be on that peak right there. I'll guarantee you that's one of them there. I think that's the one right there, and then there's one to the left. And why would they need so many forts? You know, and a lot of times when we see this stuff, we think it was built in the same era. Maybe the other forts failed. Maybe this was the last one and the best one because they found a defensible position they could actually hold. And maybe those were failures over there. You know, there's all kinds of different theories and thoughts, but you know, you just don't know. Now we're gonna try to walk around that ridgeline, I think, when we get down. You know, you see how the fire has devastated this area though. It really has. The problem with that out here is when you get a fire, it's the vegetation that holds the soil. And so you don't hold the soil, so it's extremely difficult for things to grow. But I can just imagine up here that you would have stacks of rocks all over this ridge on different locations, depending on which area they decided that they were going to try to assault you. And even though I'm not going to say it couldn't be taken, it would have been extremely difficult because, you know, if you've got, oh, look at this wall. Now, here's what's funny about this wall. This wall almost seems like something that would have been, if they get up here, kinda. You know, so this would be a secondary wall that if they make it to the ridge, you could stand behind this. You know, if you've got arrows or whatever you might have at that time, whether you've got a atlatl or whatever you might use. There's a hole through that wall there. But look at this wall. How incredible is to look across here and see this, this ancient fort. You just don't get to see things like this. How incredible is this? Unreal. I tell you what, this is an unbelievable location. And again, there's two locations to get up. I haven't seen the second one. You might have to be down below to see it. And there's another, there would have been multiple inner buildings here. You know, it's just mind-boggling when you think that I'm standing in the same location that somebody that was trying to protect their lives and their family's lives 600, 700, 800 years ago were up here contemplating that they had to protect themselves. Wow. And you know, so Southwest warfare, well, you wouldn't build four forts in a small area this small if you didn't have a massive threat of people. And the only thing you really have to save is your life. So you're not having a lot of goods that they were trying to get goods. They might have been trying to get your food if you had a abundance of food. But other than that, they're just out to get you for whatever reason that is. And you've crawled all the way up here and hand-carried every one of those rocks from some location. Wow, how incredible is that? You know, before we go down, I'm going to make one more walk around here just because, you know, and again, I'm envisioning the other side of it like I've talked about. I've talked about, you know, what it was like to come up this hill. So what's my plan? My plan is to flank out, right? I've got this defendable position right here. We've got a wall already in place. So they'd have had to come up what I would call the death chute. So they would have had to assault this death chute. And you're right here and you got people on this side and you got people on that side and you're cross-firing through here, rocks. And I'll tell you what, how tough would you have to been to take a full-blown rock to the chest or the head coming up this hill? You know, I can't even imagine the brutality and the difficulty of what it would have taken. Because here's the walls here that have come down. So they had a massive wall up here. Now, I hadn't seen many shards till right there. And they're all pretty primitive if you'll see those. Right there. Looks like a scraper of some type right there also. But, you know, this wouldn't have been a place where you lived. This is specifically for defending. Now, the amount of shards might give us a real clear cut idea how long they were up here, how long this fort was used. Because they would have had to have also had supplies to stay up here. Because one of the ideas would have been, if I had had the time and I'd have been the attacking army, I'd have waited them out. Because eventually they would have had to come down, you know, depending on how long you wanted to wait. So there's a lot of different things that comes to the strategy. And, you know, I'm not a military, so I don't understand exactly all of it, but I do have common sense and I understand what it would take to get in that role. Looky there. I mean, guys stood behind these walls. If you go across that ridge, even though I'm sure there's stuff down there, but we're gonna go back up here. We just noticed what appears to be a big piece of shard right there. Yeah, that's what it is right there. So good to see that. Now leave that there. Don't put that on a rock. Just leave it there. There we're going. We're gonna take one more walk around the loop take a look at each one of these rooms. Looks like somebody dug that. Don't look like it. I wouldn't think they would bury anyone up here, but you never know. So they had all kinds of embattlements right here. Now here's an area that might have been the other area that they've been coming up. Yes, look at that. There's the other area that you could have went up. You could have come up this ridge right here and climbed up there. So we found the second of the passages that come through here. I'm gonna get a little better view over there because that is the secondary point to come up. I was told there was two, and that is it. Now, what kind of a position would have that been? That wouldn't have been bad. That actually, yeah, you know, you never know. You can say that would be an easier way up, but you definitely see where they funneled people through the other deaths, the second death chute right there. And they would have clobbered you when you come up that ridge. I tell you what, this is a very spectacular place. But I don't think I'm gonna walk around that ridge today. You know, we do have more forts to see, so we'll walk down the center now. You guys are enjoying today. You know, I wanna give a shout out today to someone you haven't heard me talk about, my wife Deanna, my daughter Morgan. You know, they put up with a lot of me doing this. You know, and I couldn't do it without support of you guys, but I couldn't do it without support of my family who have sacrificed for this life of adventure. And I want to make sure that, you know, they understand that I couldn't do it without them. So thank you. Is that another death chute right there? That's a death drop. I wouldn't call it a death chute, but I'd call it a death drop. That's a beautiful right there. Look at that. Build something today that's lasting 800 years. That's pretty incredible. First thing you probably ought to use is material that's lasted longer than that, right? Wouldn't that make sense? Wow. Well, we're gonna see if we can't catch a few petroglyphs on the way down. So we weave through this magical place. This is definitely a magical place. So we'll just take our time and work our way down here. Man, can you imagine them? The fierceness it would take to fight somebody coming up this hill and the kahunas it would have taken to be the guy up on the hill would have been, as they say, intestinal fortitude. It would have taken a lot of that. So look at what we're coming down. And like I said, I told you guys I was going to take my time and work my way down this ridge and not do anything that's not considered to be smart. See, there's oh shit rocks everywhere here. So the reason that wasn't a big deal though was because I was ready. So doesn't look like any glyphs up there. It looks like more graffiti. So I don't know if we even want to work our way around that corner or not, around this corner over here, just to see if there's a, you know, a panel over there. We definitely don't want to fall off regardless of what we do. I want to make sure we're walking on solid ground. Didn't like that rock at all. So I don't think I see anything over here that I gotta see. So, well, I've still got good energy and I've got all the energy I need today. We're gonna weave our way back down this chute because it's gonna take a lot of work to get down there. on 2 feet. So the goal is that we make it down on 2 feet, which is not going to be the easiest thing we have ever done. So take them up. That hurt, but that's okay. Okay, so let's get down to this rock. Take our time. Get down to that space. Get down to here. Get down to here. Taking our time as we go. Might take a quick jaunt over there if I can do it without sliding down the hill. Is there any rocks? Because this is a little hairy. Yeah, there's a ton of loose rock up here. You know, we're getting ready to go down, and I'm going to take one more look up there. Look how brutal this is going up there. I still can't imagine what it would have been like trying to climb this hill and then fight to the death. You probably wouldn't have made the hill. I wonder how many guys ended up back down that hill rolling, because if you fall, you're going down the hill. You're going down this hill. So we're even looking right now on how to traverse this and what's the easiest, safest way. And I want to say that way looks better, but boy, you got a lot of loose rock. At least here you've got some ribbing, because look at this fire. This fire is taken out. Now I'm going to walk down just a little bit just to see how bad this is, to see if it's going to take me down the hill. That's not bad. It's pretty good grip right this way. Got a little hairy, and it's a little hairy right there. We're not done yet. I tell you what, this loose rock right here, it's going to be twice as hard coming down as it is going up. So that's one thing to remember when you do this, is that, you know, you're going up, it might be a tough climb up. Up's easy. It's going down. And then the other thing you got to worry about is the fact that you're going to have loose rocks on this hillside, and if you got somebody below you, they're going to take it. And so that's the only reason that I'm thinking about I need to get down. But yeah, Jay Schreck, we're getting ready to go down this hill. I'm going to work my way down this hill. And then we're going to call today a day. You know, I don't know if we're going to get to another mountain today. Probably not by the time we get done, but that's okay. We had a great one today. What an awesome place. This was Delta in the group of four forts. And again, a big deal to me is that they spent time. We did see some shards, and I know there's some glyphs on here, but I'm really not that interested to walk this ridge to find them, to be real honest with you. I wanted to see the ruins, and I wanted to get up the top to the first fort in a fort of four in the Tonto National Forest. How unbelievable is this? It is an incredible place. Look at the view that you get when you get up here. Wow. Breathtaking. Black Flag Expeditions, hey, thanks for everybody that donates. We have a live show every Tuesday night at 7 o'clock. So, yeah, please join in, comment. We're really building that live show up. We're going to start to have guests on there. We're going to get new. It's going to be more of a show, you could say. So you're not going to want to miss that. And again, thanks for everybody that supports us. And have a great day and trek on. And, man, I'll see you later. Adios, amigos.
Yeah, oh my Lord, watch me sway. Darkness falls and we all pray, hoping for the light of day.
down to the river. I have held the devil's hand, felt the weight of my own.